Testing, testing. First, I want us all to take a moment to thank the veterans who are here with us this afternoon. We are grateful, and this is your capital. Now, today we're seeing a little bit of what I at least call Team Kentucky, and that's when we come together to do the right thing. We have a lot of dignitaries that are here with us, and if I miss anybody, my apologies, but we can make sure they are recognized. We have Representative Michael Meredith, Representative Hart, Representative Patty Minter, Representative Philip Pratt, Representative Steve Sheldon, Representative Brandon Reed, Representative Bart Rowland, Representative Wilson Stone, Representative Walker Thomas, Representative Melinda Gibbons, Representative Steve Riley, Senator Mike Wilson, one of my favorite mayors, Bowling Green Mayor Bruce Wilkerson. Then we also have our Kentucky Department of Veteran Affairs Commissioner Keith Jackson. We have the Deputy Commissioner Dean Stoops. We have a representative from the Bowling Green Chamber of Commerce, Terry Daniels. And then we have the commanders of the Vietnam Veterans of America, AMVETS, JEFCO, Military Officers of America, the Navy League, and we have our Adjutant General, Hal Lamberton. So you can tell we have a full house today to honor our veterans. Today, I am proud to sign House Bill 24. Legislation which appropriates $2.5 million to the Kentucky Department of Veterans Affairs. This will fund the design and pre-construction costs of a new Bowling Green Veterans Center, which will be a long-term skilled nursing care facility. Unless there are unforeseen delays, we expect the center to be open about 2 years after the construction starts. Once completed, this will be the fifth Veterans Center in our state. Our veterans are heroes to all Kentuckians and to all Americans. The Bowling Green Veterans Center will show our gratitude for their service and sacrifice in a tangible way, and I could not be more excited to get this project underway. I want to congratulate Representative Meredith on this milestone. I know this has been a dream of his for more than 5 years, and I'm thrilled to be able to help move this important project forward. House Bill 24 was one of the first pieces of legislation to pass the General Assembly this session. That means it was one of the first pieces I was able to sign into law as governor, and I can't imagine a more fitting bill and a more fitting project to be one of the first. It speaks to the hard work, and it speaks to Kentucky's commitment to our veterans. You know, just last month in this room, we had the honor of recognizing four of our state's World War II veterans as Kentucky colonels. They were Sergeant Jim Etheridge of Trigg County, Staff Sergeant Henry Breithop of Christian County, Corporal Elwood Richardson of Christian County, and Corporal Howard Bentley of Greenup County. You learn new things in this job every day. I thought with everything that they had done and the ranks that they had earned, a Kentucky colonel, it was nice. But let me tell you, it was special. It was a special moment, a special day. You could especially see it on their families' faces that every time we honor our veterans, it's not only felt by our veterans, it's felt by their families. Now, these individuals and all of our veterans risked everything to protect their fellow Kentuckians, their fellow Americans, and their brothers and sisters across the world. It is our turn to take care of them. The same week we celebrated these World War II veterans, I was also proud to posthumously promote Colonel Charles Young to Brigadier General here in Kentucky. His groundbreaking dedication, moral courage, and selfless service are an example to them all. Colonel Young was the highest serving African-American officer in the Army for decades. The only reason he wasn't promoted to general was views on race at the time, and I was glad that posthumously we could do the right thing here in Kentucky. Our veterans chose to serve because they didn't just want to talk about the ideals our country stands for, they wanted to fight for them. They wanted to protect us at our time of greatest need. They wanted to take action in the face of fear and of uncertainty. Today, we don't just say thank you. We take action to protect and to support those veterans. Representative Meredith and our veterans today, I am so excited to have this opportunity. I'm going to call on Representative Meredith and then Lieutenant Colonel Jackson, our commissioner, and at that point, we'll sign this bill. Representative Meredith.
Thank you. Congratulations. Thank you. Very excited.
I want to start by echoing the governor's comments. We want to thank all of the veterans who are here and those who couldn't be here today with us for their service to our country, their bravery, and their courage. But I also want to thank the governor for stepping up and for signing this bill. This has been a long time coming, Governor. This process started around 2012. We're 8 years down the road, and this is the next step in the process that moves us towards actually being able to see real change on the site, a hopefully groundbreaking coming soon. And I'm so proud of the work that we are doing in a bipartisan way today by signing this bill and the work that's been done in passing it in the General Assembly. I want to specifically thank all the co-sponsors that are here, specifically the Warren County delegation and the South Central delegation, South Central Kentucky delegation, but all of those who are here as well. And I want to thank also Senator Mike Wilson, who shepherded this bill through the State Senate. Thank you very much. But I also want to bring a little attention to some folks that led this charge much before even I was involved in this process. I've been working on this now for nearly 5 years. But I have two people on this stage who mean a lot to me in this process as well. And Ray Biggerstaff, thank you for your work in pre-planning all this and working to get this to where I could be a part of this process. And then I also want to thank retired Colonel Bob Spiller, whose father, Colonel Robert Spiller, was instrumental in working with Ray and I and others in this process to give me the opportunity to move this forward in the Kentucky legislature. Without the leadership of these men and the other veterans groups in Warren County and South Central Kentucky, I would have never had the opportunity to work on this like I have over the last 5 years. And so thank you all for being here, for representing yourselves and your family today. Governor, again, thank you for signing this. Commissioner, thank you for being a willing participant in this process as well. And again, thank you to all of our interested parties, the Bowling Green Chamber for being willing to donate the land and the trans park for this. The other thing that I have been really excited about in this process and has been a driving force in my mind through all this, my wife's grandfather, Clyde Henderson Spinks Jr., was a World War II veteran. And there's a strong likelihood that when this facility is done, it may sit on a piece of ground that he once farmed many years ago. And so that's another driving force in this for me personally, and I thank you all for being a part of this process.
Thank you.
Next, we've got Lieutenant Colonel Keith Jackson, Commissioner of the Kentucky Departments of Veterans Affairs. Keith, like so many of our veterans, returned from service to serve more, serving as the chief of the fire department in Lexington and so many other roles. One of the most inspiring parts about our veterans is it seems like every single one comes back to their community and finds a way to continue to serve, you know, his fellow man. So, Lieutenant Colonel Jackson.
Good afternoon. I'm pleased to join Governor Beshear, House Bill 24, co-sponsors, members of the Bowling Green delegation, VMAP committee members, and veterans in the office today. Thank you for those who diligently worked to make Bowling Green Veterans Center site selection and pre-construction a reality. House Bill 24 authorizes $2.5 million in funding for the design and pre-construction cost for the Bowling Green Veterans Center, long sought by the Commonwealth, veterans and their families. This facility will serve the South Central region of Kentucky. The Department of Veteran Affairs is grateful to the Bowling Green Chamber of Commerce for their generosity in donating the land for the facility. We look forward to our continued joint efforts with the Bowling Green community and business leaders. We could not go without recognizing Representative Meredith, Senator Wilson, and the entire Bowling Green delegation for their efforts. We're excited about the partnership with Western Kentucky University, the South Central Kentucky Community Technical College, and recruiting and retaining qualified nursing for the facility. Mm-hmm. Governor Beshear, with your leadership, we look forward to having a groundbreaking ceremony in the Bowling Green area within the next year or so as the department receives federal matching funds for the project. So thank you. God bless you. God bless the Commonwealth of Kentucky.
Are you ready? All right. At this time, we'll do the signing.
Yeah.
Y'all,
okay.
Y'all come around too.
Come on. This is the actual bill.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
The majority of Warren County folks, get up here as close as you can for sure.
Are we ready?
Let's go.
All right.
We're all opposed.
And it is official. Congratulations to everybody. Senator Wilson, for there you are.
Oops.
There, that's okay. Thank you. And I'll tell you what, for those that helped shepherd it through, feel free
Steve,
to give the honors.
Patty, for sure. Let's get the Warren County folks
card.
Wilson, you've got a little piece of Warren County.
Right.